that there's healing available for introverts who have been labeled as shy or feel like they are misplaced in their calling. You're still secure in self as an introvert. You may say, oh, but Angela, I'm so socially awkward. I'm awkward too. In our own weird way, all of us are all awkward. Today I've got the Women's Convention at KICC and then I have Mercy Surprise in the evening. So the point of this video is basically to show, highlight the different characters that creators have and to explain why we should not be boxed into a particular character or personality. And that may sound vague, but I'm going to explain. This weekend I'm going to be out quite a bit and I'm going to be online, I'm going to be up and about. I'm gonna try and vlog as much as possible and get my introvert self out the house. What I'm thinking is that I might have to, let me put the light on because we're all about good lighting. Okay, this is not working. How do we like my hair? Do you like it? Yeah, so basically, I feel like... Don't mind my tabs, like... So, tiara, tiara, tiara. So, this is the party collection. Is this one, actually? Oh, can't click it. Don't know why I thought I should do that. This is a dress. I was thinking of wearing it either this way or... See, the video shows it better. Oh, this is a nice way. Okay, but yeah, look at that. That's really nice. Yes, yeah, so I'm wearing the sample size 8 for day. I just got my toes done. I'm gonna give you a close up, but I am ready for the fashion show. My little vibe, you know. This is making it easier to vlog now because there's nobody here, but. I'm at church waiting for the church bus to come to take us to the bigger branch. And what a morning. So basically, I was meant to film like 2 videos this morning. I was meant to film the intro for my room renovation and this video, the intro up. But I clearly thought I woke up early enough, but I didn't. And then I didn't like my outfit. I think that's somebody from the church transport team. I don't know, it's mad because like, I'm the only one here, so everyone was on time. But the thing is, like, they even give a time bracket, but I still went past that time bracket. What if God made me late so I can make this video? What if because the lighting is not this good in my room. I feel quite passionate about this. I don't even want to sit down and talk. People don't talk about how some of you have to grow into the job of being an influencer or a creator. For some people, it comes quite naturally, the idea of being very outgoing and speaking to people at events. So some of us don't have that natural flair of being outgoing on camera. You actually have to build it. And I feel like it's assumed that influencers are outgoing and that they are comfortable with the camera immediately all the time, that they don't have to grow into it. And if you're not that way, then maybe it's just not for you, or you're not cut out to be an influencer. But my issue with that is that if we're really going to say that this thing is a job, then tell me if you go into your job in the office and you go in on the first day and you immediately know everything that you need to do. You have all the skills, you have all the other tools to succeed and to be promoted or to do better, whatever it is. I think if we're gonna treat it as a job, then we should understand that there are levels of growth. Like, you don't go into a company the same and leave the same. That would be quite boring. There's a growth journey. So where people are called to be influencers and creators, on their first day, their first week, even their first year, because it's a lot, and because it's not like a 9 to 5 day to day, sometimes your growth doesn't happen as linear as somebody who's in a 9 to 5. So what I mean by growth is like the confidence building of like vlogging outside is may come later than, how do I explain this? Like vlogging for some people is not every day. It may be like they vlog when they go out. If you don't go out every day, then you're not constantly building that skill every day. So it may take a bit longer to build, if that makes sense. If you need to build confidence in going to like, in speaking to people and like brand events aren't every day. So you can't build that kind of confidence every day, if that makes sense. Do you see where I'm going with this? But with a 9 to 5 where you go to work every single day, I feel like you can easily kind of grow at a more gradual, linear, consistent basis. Whereas with content, there's some days you pick it up, you do it, you bulk content, and then 2 weeks you leave it, and then sometimes you have to rejig your memory, like, oh yeah, this is what I do. Like, on top of that, with creating, you are employing yourself, you are your own boss per se. God is my boss. But so you are the one training yourself in these skills. If you don't know how to edit, you have to learn. You either take a masterclass or whatever. In my case, I just learn by myself, looking at other videos, of course, but like I learn by myself. If you need to learn how to build people skills, like, you do that yourself. Like, all of these things are not really taught by like a supervisor or a manager or a higher person in the company. You are the company. I realized I haven't really gone into the term introvert. I feel like it's very diversely defined by many people. So I understand that what I'm thinking may not relate to what you're thinking. So I'm going to explain what I'm thinking. So I just typed in what does the Bible say about introverts on Google. And I think the disconnect that I'm seeing between that and my mind is that I don't really think an introvert is somebody who's like really, really shy to themselves and like really, what's the word, unsociable at all. There's a difference between being quiet and reserved. I think being reserved, you can be very confident, you can actually have a bubbly personality like me, but you just don't, like, it's just something you don't naturally show outside. I don't know how to explain it, but I know that there's people who feel that way, where it's just like you sometimes question, wait, but like I'm like this in one scenario, but in another scenario I just naturally don't behave that way. Whereas with others, they naturally can be bubbly and outgoing wherever they go. What does God say about introverts? What does God say about us? For me, this isn't actually about being shy. I think it's about being labeled as shy just because you don't behave in a particular way. And when I think more, where I'm speaking more related to like influencing and creating, the issue isn't that you want to change from being an introvert, like you'll find the way that you are, you'll find the way that your character is. The issue is that in spaces where you go to like events, or you go to, what else do influencers do? Do you know what I mean? Like in spaces where you do that and you are not typically outgoing like the rest of the people, you're automatically kind of labeled as shy or like not outgoing. And I guess it doesn't fit your character, it doesn't fit your job role. But my issue isn't about changing that. My issue is about creating a space for that. Another struggle for me is because I'm an introvert, I sometimes feel like I'm not cut out for the industry because typically I don't behave in an extrovert way. Sometimes I watch vlogs and I see people like bring out their camera in like wherever, or they're like at an event and they're really like outgoing and talking to everyone. And I'm like, I speak to myself, I'm like, Angela, would you be like this if you was there? Like, and it's bad because it's like a comparison thing, but I just have to ask myself sometimes, would I? Don't be thinking that I'm gonna be in the corner share like this, whatever. Like, I actually do talk. I actually, you'd be surprised. But I mean, like, in comparison. Guys, my birthday is next month and I really want a camera because I'm tired of holding my phone and I wanna be able to read my notes at the same time. I actually don't know if I'm getting to church today. I don't know. Service starts at 10. It's 9:35 and service is in Kent. I'm in London. It's an hour drive. Guys, the bus is here.
Let me go. I want to go to church.
I don't know if... Oh, how do I open this? The only one here. Oops. The get. Yeah.
Yeah, come in.
Thank you.
I just need to clean the.
Okay.
I'm the only one on this bus. This is not good. This is bad.
So much of what was said, I think it's definitely how you say it, not exactly what you say. Thankfully, growing up, my parents did allow me to have an opinion. Sometimes how I said it was a problem, so I did definitely get the repercussions for that. But
hello everyone, good afternoon men and women. Thank you so much to Pastor the MC for giving me this opportunity, I really appreciate it. And if you would all permit me, could we just welcome and just appreciate some of those young people that I'm passionate about, they're just over there.
We live. That's real alcohol.
Are you crazy? Straight from Russia.
Guys, today's video is about being an introvert as a creator.
Like,
right?
Like, I think it's so hard when we get into environments and people force us to be extroverted, but it's like, realistically, I just want to curl up in a ball and
listen
to myself.
When I entered, I wanted to lose the weight. I was like,
but you know, networking and all these things, I just think it's crazy, especially with social media now, because we're meant to promote ourselves. What if myself
you
doesn't...
Are
I'm not a brother. That's who God says I am. And let me even stop preaching.
It's the towel neck! It's the towel neck! It's the towel neck!
I feel fine.
Can he preach?
Jesus didn't need no act to tell him to be real.
Come on.
I will gladly say I'm not one of them, but
this is my struggle.
I think yeah, if you're introvert and you're creative, yeah. No one's saying you need to be extroverted, but you need to learn that there are moments where you may need to be extroverted.
Good.
And you might have to exercise that. Only because if you don't, no one will know who you are. You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm gonna say. Learn from your friends who are extrovert where to be like that in moments. Sometimes it's needed.
So good. We appreciate that.
No worries.
Oh, I just came back from church. I want to show you guys my outfit. Guys, I wasn't filming this whole time, so I don't actually know what I said. But essentially, I'm waiting for my dad to come back so that he can take me. I'm going to do a little filming sesh. And we'll be off in my dress from Yara Fashion. I'm going to try it on for the first time. My phone has no storage, so it keeps going off. But guys, this is the dress. Hopefully, I'll get better footage at the event. Also, just continuing the conversation, like for me, where I feel like I've been called to this industry, I feel like God is helping me to become more outgoing of a character. More outgoing in my character and confident, but it doesn't mean that I'm necessarily changing it. And where yesterday I was talking about how some of us like naturally have things, other of us don't, I think even with being a creative, like some of us are naturally creative and others of us actually have to learn all of these things of how to be more creative. So it just goes to show that there's different skills that you need to learn as a creator.
This is my debut collection and I'm happy to see the excitement on my faces. Just a little story that inspired this piece.
Hey guys, morning. Different setting, different day. We are off to church again, Sunday. So, struggles of being an introvert, I was talking about yesterday. Going to events, I kind of spoke about a little bit. I think it can be difficult to interact sometimes. But something yesterday that one of my friends said, JA, he said that it's good to go with an extroverted friend if you ever go into like these events. And I do agree, like they kind of balance you out and they also push you out of your comfort zone in a way. Another thing that might be a bit niche is trying to remain authentic, like trying not to seem inauthentic. So for me personally, I'm a bubbly person. I'm fun, I'm funny, I can be loud when I want to, right? But and on camera you may see that, you may see that kind of bubbly personality even though I am reserved, but in person you may not always see that. But it doesn't mean that my character isn't inconsistent, it's just like sometimes I have those moments where I'm shy. It doesn't mean that I'm sad, it doesn't mean that I don't want to be around people necessarily, but it really depends where I am. So that one is hard to describe. Even with my event, like if you saw me there, I was the most confident, I was there, I was hosting, I was doing everything cool. But I think that came because I was, number one, very very passionate about my event. I was very very excited, and also I was the one leading it, so I didn't have an excuse. I couldn't be like I was had to be like boom boom boom, like this is what we got to do, like. And yeah, now we're going to talk about what does the Lord say about introverts. Welcome to Angela's School of Psychology. Lucky for you, I have a psychology degree and proven experience of studying both introversion and extroversion in university. Both personality traits, introversion and extroversion, are part of the big five, which basically boils our personality down to five factors. And you know, with psychology, there's always a lot of people involved, but the person who coined this was Donald Fisk. And then Carl Jung, or Jung, how you say his name, he was the one that introduced introversion and extroversion. So even if you don't do psychology, a lot of us know about the nature nurture debate of whether things are biological or environmental. I think now the nature nurture debate surrounds the interaction of the both, which basically states that some things are biological, as in genetic, and other things are environmental. So the research shows the same for introversion and extroversion, which basically states that introversion and extroversion is biological. In other words, God created you either as an introvert or an extrovert, and that is fixed. However, there are environmental influences, meaning that you can learn or adopt introvert behavior as an extrovert, and you can learn or adopt extrovert behavior as an introvert. There's an article I want to show you guys. Let me find it. Yeah, so basically what I said, it says that showing that God created these differences at biological level, which means introversion and extroversion are not a matter of choice or habit, but of basic nature, human nature. In other words, introverts cannot become extroverts, though they can learn extroverted behavior. Similarly, extroverts cannot become introverts, though they can learn introverted behavior. So I say all of this to say, all of this information, context, background to say, that there's healing available for introverts who have been labeled as shy or feel like they are misplaced in their calling. This is really also important for extroverts to listen to as well, because we are all one body in Christ who have been called to serve each other in different ways, and we need to understand the ways that God has called our brothers and sisters to serve and how it may not look like ourselves.
Right.
Introversion and shyness are two different things. To be shy is to be afraid or timid in the presence of other people's company. We know that this isn't of God, because he said in 2 Timothy 1 verses 7, for God has not given you a spirit of fear, some versions say timidity, but of power, love, and sound mind. So shyness is not introversion. Got it? God would never make you shy. This psychology article puts it perfectly. Introversion is a basic personality style characterized by a preference for the inner life of the mind over the outer world, of other people. One of the big five dimensions that define all personalities, introversion sits on the continuum at the opposite end of which is extroversion. Compared to extroverts, introverts enjoy subdued and solitary experiences. Key words: introverts do not fear or dislike others, and they are not shy or plagued by loneliness. And they talked about all of the scientific stuff in the brain, because it is a brain wiring that makes you introvert or extrovert. And they gave the example of a party and how introverts would behave in that kind of scenario. And then the next article says introversion is often mistaken for shyness because both are characterized by limited social interaction. But the thing is, shyness is typically people who actually want to engage with others, but they physically can't. Like, they can't because they're scared. They are self-conscious. Whereas introverts, on the other hand, they can socialize, like they can actually go up to you, but they just choose not to. So it's more of a choice thing. They just prefer to speak in small groups, if you know what I mean. You're still secure in self as an introvert. You may say, oh, but Angela, I'm so socially awkward. I'm awkward too. In our own weird way, all of us are all awkward. It's because introverts process information more differently and sometimes more slowly. So it may appear more awkward to people. You're not actually weird. Like, I want you guys to understand, like, God wouldn't create you to be scared to talk to people. I feel like this is just this perverted concept that we've created between introvert and extrovert, pitting it together and trying to make it seem like one is bad and the other is better. The goal isn't actually for everybody to be extrovert. Like, our goal in life isn't for every introvert person to become extrovert in the end. Like, you're number one, you're not going to be, because it is biological and it's the way that God has created you. And number two, your goal isn't that. You'll find the way you are. So I think, what does God say to introvert creators? I think God says that your opportunity will not be missed and it will not lack because you don't look or sound like the others. He's saying that there's a presence you have, that your presence alone will take you places, it will carry you, and there's a grace upon your head that means you don't always have to speak or be the loudest in the room for you to be seen, for you to be noticed. God has a way of creating you to be noticed. That's his job. The enemy is so annoying. He's using, guys, the revelation God gave me yesterday on the bus when I was going to church. Oh my gosh. You think these small things, the enemy will pick out this introversion, extroversion, things that we don't care about. The enemy is using personality traits to pit people against each other, including Christians. He's putting us against each other and trying to make us desire our partner's trait. If your friend or your colleague or whatever is extrovert and you are introvert, you're now desiring to be extrovert. You're saying, oh, I wish I was like them. I wish I was more outgoing. If you're extrovert and your friend is introvert, you're trying to be introvert. Oh, I wish I was more quiet. Maybe I talk too much. No, you're fine. God wants introverts to hone in on what they do have, not what they don't have. For me, I have a reserved yet inquisitive nature, maybe like John in the Bible. That's from the article that I read. They mentioned John and I was like, maybe John kind of gives that vibe. He's kind of a person that seems like he wants to study things, like the intricate details, and then speak later, maybe, kind of vibe. And because I'm the kind of person that typically doesn't have the most, like, my, I don't have the most long-lasting energy in group settings, when I do speak, I try to evaluate what I say and make sure that it is fruitful and said well, I guess. What I'm not saying is that you now go to places and you only speak when you feel like you're going to say something fruitful and cool. No. But I think it depends on the setting. For example, yesterday at Mercy Surprise, that's a completely different setting. You just talk to everybody, you just bouncy, bubbly kind of vibe. But I feel like in other settings, for example, maybe like if I was to go to an event and I'm speaking to other different people, besides the part of getting to know people, which is just kind of like standard for me, when I'm saying something or bringing something to a conversation, I typically, I'm not saying everybody is like this, but the way I typically speak is just based on what I feel like needs to be said. And I feel like that's something that takes training, I'm not gonna lie, unless you have it. Because for me, I didn't used to be like that. I had to train myself to be like that, but that's so separate. Anyway, people notice that I enjoy small conversations. I enjoy deep conversations. I tend to be that deep kind of person. I like to sit in my friend's room and talk for hours. I feel like that's where I pour out myself the most, or on camera like this, where I'm just talking to you guys. And it feels like it's just me and you guys in the room, but obviously I'm not seeing like who's seeing it. if anything, being a creative is perfect for you as an introvert, because sometimes it can just be you and your camera and you speak and you say the most wise thing that you could ever say, and one person will pick you up on the street and they'll say, that girl with the camera, that girl, I like that video, I like what she's doing, let's give her this opportunity. Or you can be in a small group of people, like I said, talking, having a conversation, and you could be with people you don't even know, but some person can pick up on what you said and they can be like this person in one of those high places, and they can be like, oh, I like this girl, I like what she's saying, and they can recommend you to somebody else who's in another high place, who knows another person. You know, the industry is just so small. Someone who can recommend you and change your life. So what I'm trying to say, what God is trying to say, is don't despise your personality the way it is. Do not despise your personality the way it is. That's what God says about you.